So I've removed the screws from the top. I've removed the electric choke, which is right here. And a little clip that holds the choke line, the choke actuator cable on the choke heater. And I'm ready to remove the cover. There's the gaskets on here, the float. And if I turn this up in the light, you can see how much this really needs to be cleaned. And that's really the next step. That's not going to be very interesting to watch, but I'm going to take some carburetor cleaner that I've got here and go ahead and start cleaning the outside of the body, the inside of the throats of the carburetor. And when I get down to further disassembly, I'll start the video up again. So I started cleaning and I discovered a problem I wanted to document here, which is that the accelerator sticks when it gets all the way to full wide open throttle, which is something you really wouldn't want to hear. So watch, I'll show you what I mean. I can't really do this one-handed, but there, see? If you open the throttle all the way and just let go, it stays wide open. It doesn't come back. And that needs to get fixed. And I think I discovered the problem, or the source of the problem, is it's over here on the, looks like the accelerator pump. This right here, I think, is the source of the problem. This cam lobe, or whatever it is that actuates the accelerator pump. When it gets all the way up there like that, it sticks. So I'm gonna work on cleaning that up, maybe sand it or file it down a little bit so that it works better. Okay, the carburetor is rebuilt and ready to go back in the Land Cruiser. Nothing really interesting, just lots of dirt to clean out. And I replaced parts from the rebuild kit, so a new accelerator valve and so on. And I've preset the idle adjustments. They're in the middle of the range that the factory says, the manufacturer says they should be. And so we'll put it on the vehicle. I checked it, the spark and the compression, so if the carburetor works, the engine should start. Maybe that'll be the next video. So I put the carburetor back on the engine and tried to start it up yesterday, but there is no fuel coming out of the fuel pump, and so the engine, of course, didn't start. And so I traced this fuel line you're looking at here on back down and discovered that the mechanical fuel pump has been removed and replaced with this electric fuel pump, which I took out and tested and doesn't work. So that's going to be kind of the end of the video for the day, because we're not going to be able to start the engine until I get another fuel pump. So stay tuned for another little mini episode. Okay, so when we left off, I had finished rebuilding the carburetor, but it wasn't running. The engine wasn't running yet because of a problem with the fuel pump. So I've taken the fuel pump out and replaced it. Also, while I was in here, discovered some sort of substandard wiring and stuff, so I needed to work on that. I still do, by the way. So here's the new fuel pump. And here's one of the wires that I need to fix, which is the power for the fuel pump that's just been connected to the fuse panel, and then it ran under this piece of wood. Also took up that piece of wood, and there's some rust under there that I'm going to need to take care of. Unfortunately, the key has been lost for this vehicle, so I've got a jury-rigged ignition switch here and a new starter switch, but I'll go ahead and turn on the ignition and show you what I got here. We got a working motor. Runs good.